Hello and welcome to 9design3D. Today we will make an Instagram Reel style retro car inside animation. First thing first, we will download something from the SketchFab. Add this add-on to your Blender file. I showed before how to download and import some models from there. You can go from the top right card. I search as an interior car and I found this car model. You can check it. I will use only inside camera angles for my animation. Thanks Comrade for this good model. Let's import it. After import, you can delete some unnecessary parts for your animation scene. As you see, the interior dashboard is really cool. If you want, you can change your focal length of your camera or the wide look. As you see, that is too heavy for our scene. If you can't see, the right click for the scene statistic and check it. For this make a bit light scene, I will add a decimate modifier for my car. You can decrease your ratio or you can give some value. Please be careful, don't lose your details. Now I will use my old scene. I made this car chase animation before. I made a tutorial series for this, how to download some buildings, how to make some 3D builds from the image, or how to make particle system for this whole scene. I showed everything. You can go from there, from the top right car, for car chase animation tutorial you can find on my channel. I will append this whole city to my other Blender project. First, I will add this city for the new collection as an old city. We will correct this particle system issue. I will show this. Go to your new Blender file, choose append scene and choose your collection. After that, it will come in here. You can scale or delete some part of it for how you want. You can use this city. For the correct particle system, go to render after the choose plane. As you see, instance collection is a buildings, but first add new collection to our this particle buildings. Now you can choose your buildings collection for this and it will show again. As you see, we will use this road. Before all of this, to do my scene, I added some area lights as a 500 power. I added a sunlight for the give whole lightness to my scene. If you want, you can download some neon signs to your project. I will download this Taiwan style signboard for my roads and city. Thanks for the solar for these good models. You can import them. If you want, you can Ctrl J to join some the separated part for this. And for example, I will choose this sign and G to move. Place it near of a buildings, how you want, where you want, you can use this. You can change from material settings to this emission strength. For example, I will use this for the top of a building. You can Ctrl J to join them, apply all transform and set origin to geometry. It will be quick tied up for this. As you see, our scene will look like that. First thing first, let's add some fog to our scene for making a bit retro and mystic scene. Add your cube and cover up all your road. Add a new material as a fog. Delete principal BSDF and Shift A. Add principled volume. Connect volume to volume. As you see, it came in here. Add a noise texture. And between them, add a color ramp. Connect fact to fact and color ramp's color to the principal's volumes. Emission strength. You can decrease your density. For the color ramps, black note, you can slide it and check your fog how you want. If you want, you can change your scale from the noise texture and detail on the principled volume. You can change your appearance and color. Maybe one, you can make it purple or yellowish. Now it's time to add an empty cube for moving our car. Choose all car parts After that, as a last selection, choose your empty, Ctrl-P and Object Keep Transform. When you move your empty, you can see whole car can be moved. After set your camera angle, we will give some keyframe it too. As the same method, I will connect it to my cube too. And now, press I and insert keyframe location rotation scale. On the timeline, you can press Ctrl-T as you can see how many seconds you can use your animation from the bottom. Go to timelines, middle part. Move your empty along the x-axis and I location rotation scale and set your keyframe. As you see, your car is moving now. Go to last keyframe on your timeline and move along the x-axis your car again and press I location rotation scale. We will make a simple animation, so we will use only them. If you want, you can add some extra light for your scene. It can be a bit laggy in the render to you. For the car steering, you can add some keyframes to this. You can rotate it a bit and rotate the different axis for this. Set some keyframes, as I said before, I location rotation scale. You can get some keyframe for this. And before the render animation, go to output settings. You can set your resolution, frame rate and FPS, and choose your output folder. After that, choose your FFmpeg as a file format, and as an encoding, you can choose your MPEG-4. And after that, press render animation. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.